In this video, I'm going to be showing you how to use one of the features of the latest version of Revit, Revit 2024, and that's going to be bar bending details in Revit. So we now have the ability to just take our reinforcement and generate bar bending details and just place them on views. It's easy, just a few clicks, and I'm going to be showing you the whole workflow. Let's go. Now, quickly before we jump into Revit, make sure to check out my website, balkanarchitect.com. I'm going to link it up in the cards above and then also down in the description below this video. If you're serious about learning Revit, that's definitely the best place to be. I've got over 140 hours of content and I'm adding more each month. So now, without any further ado, let's jump straight into Revit. To demonstrate placement of bar bending details in plan views, I'm going to be showing you on this example project. So this is from the concrete and reinforcement template, which you can find on balkanarchitect.com. And if you're interested, I'm just going to link it up in the cards above. So anyways, I'm going to go here to our level two to reinforcement and then open up one of the sections for the beams. So here you can see we have a lot of rebar in this section. And let's say we want to now create some bending details. So what I'm going to do is I can either select one of the rebar elements, and then here we have the bending detail button, or alternatively, what you can do is go to the annotate tab, and there on the symbol panel, we have the rebar bending detail. I actually prefer this option because it's going to show you what you can select and use, and then also you can select the multiple ones and so on. So first, to show you some of the options that you have here on the modify panel, we have the align to bar. So this basically means is if you select one of these, is it going to go straight down, left, or straight left to right? So is it going to go into kind of ortho mode, or can you move it around freely? I actually prefer this option. So I'm just going to escape out of that just to go back. Also, you have parallel to view, which is going to allow you to only select elements which are parallel to view. So as you can see, it kind of disqualifies a lot of these and puts them in a kind of halftone presentation. Then we have the option for multiple selections. So if you want to select multiple elements, you can just like that. And then you can also clear the selection or create the details. So you have that option. So see, this would look something like this. And it's actually going to kind of place it pretty in a pretty good order. I'm actually quite happy with this. So actually, I'm just going to go back and undo this. Okay, moving forward, let's go back to our bending detail. And then also I want to show you something that's important, which is tag rebar. Now, this is important because you can only tag these bending details now, once you're creating them. Once you've created your bending detail, it's done. You can no longer tag it, at least from my experience. If you know kind of a workaround, please tell me in the comment section below. So anyways, I'm just going to leave that, keep that turned on. I'm just going to uncheck the multiple selection, and I'm going to keep the parallel to view unchecked, and I'm just going to select the align to bar or keep it kind of toggled on. And then let's select this one, and then we can move it down, see how it's going to show that tag here on top. Now I can select this one, move it down, place it there. I can select the top one, place it there. And then finally for this one, perhaps I can move it and place it here. And you can see the tag showing up above. Okay, so once we have everything in order, we can just click away and it's going to exit that menu. Now, what you'll notice is you can still move these things around like so. I can just go back and back. You can also select the tags and you can move them freely wherever you want. And then also what you can do is you can rotate them. Now you can select it and then use the rotate tool, or alternatively you can select it and use the rotate parameter in the properties panel. So if I set this to 30, it's going to rotate like so. I don't want that, so I'm just going to undo that change. Now, something else that you'll notice is that it doesn't really matter where your crop view is. So if I go down here and turn on the crop view visibility, you can see it's obviously turned on. However, even though these are outside of the crop view, they're still going to be visible. So that's just something to keep in mind. And here you can see, I've selected a few more items. I can just move these up like so. Can play around with the positioning if I want, and then make sure you move the tags as well. Now, speaking of tags, you can select the tags and then you can go here to the properties panel and you can actually adjust the tag family or the family type. So if I want just to show the diameter, I can go with that. If I want the number of bars plus the diameter, we have that. We can use distance and so on and so forth. So any one of these I can set here and I have that option. So I'm just going to go with this option here. You can also customize how this display looks by going here into edit type, and then here you have, as you can see, a very large set of parameters, and you can play around with these. So for example, something that you might want to change is going to be the dimension style. So here you can go and you can pick out one of the other dimension styles. So if I pick this one, for example, and click OK, hit apply, OK, it's going to change that style to something a bit smaller. If I go back, there we go. So it was like this. So you can kind of change it, play around with it. Now you can also show the length as text, but you can also show it as a dimension. Now what I'm going to do in this case is instead of changing this type, I can actually create a new type. So I can duplicate this basically a bending detail presentation type, and then I can just say bending detail custom. Click OK, and now I can make some changes. So for example, instead of show as text, I'm just going to show this as dimension. I'm also going to add the hook angles and bend diameter and so on, hit apply, OK. So now it's going to look like this. So as you can see, we have actual dimensions. We have the diameter here showing for the bending diameter and so on, but it's only affecting this one because only this one has that family type selected. This one has just the regular one, so it doesn't have that one, but of course we can customize it if we want. So you can kind of play around with that. So if I just go back here into edit type, I can use, instead of the radial dimension, I can use a diameter dimension, hit apply, okay, so that's going to make some changes. So you can play around with these and set them however you like. Now one more situation that I would like to show you is, what do you want to do where you have a varying set of rebar? So here I have this particular column, and let's say I want to create a bending detail for our stirrups, and then what I want to do is I want to show, well, the difference that we have this type on top and then this type here on the bottom of the column. Well, if I go back here to this view, what I can do is I can select this and then I can go to bending detail, and if I just click, it's going to place that bottom one. Now I can also go to annotate and then go to bar bending detail, and now I can use the tab key to just select this one and place it here, and I have even tagged this one, so like that. So we have tags actually for both of these, and actually don't like the tags here, so I'm just going to select them and delete those. So there we go. We can even place these bar bending details in situations where we have a column with a varying set. Now obviously you can place bending details for as many of these as you want. Let's go to bending detail and then go to multiple selection and then go to create details. It's going to go crazy and place them like this on top of each other, and then you can kind of show all of them if you want. Now, I don't think this is necessary. I think it's a way better option to use just a schedule at this point. And that's going to conclude today's video. Now, if you're interested in checking out a whole course on reinforcement in Revit and just generally reinforced concrete structures, I have that course on my website, balkanarchitect.com. So I'm just going to leave a link to that course up in the cards above so you can check it out. Thank you for watching, guys. Make sure to check out my website, balkanarchitect.com, for more Revit courses. There I have over 120 hours of content, and I'm adding more each week. Make sure to subscribe for more videos, and also I've added a video over there that might interest you as well.